Hello everyone, this is kEhYo, and in this video I'm going to show you my setup for investigating Clemente Figueras generator. This is this little device, a transformer type. We have Arduino here, power supply not turned on yet. Arduino is powered by USB cable coming from my computer, and it's working now. The circuit is very simple. As you can see, I have two transistors, MOSFET transistors. It's from the IRL series, which means that the gate can be operated at 5 volts only. This is because Arduino allows only 5 volts on the output, so it's very convenient for me. The power in goes here, negative, and a positive goes here through 0.01 ohm resistor. So the basic principle is this: we got both primaries and a secondary in the middle, this I-beam. As you can see, or maybe not so clearly, there are two diodes there indicating both of the outputs. I can change the frequency to about 500 hertz when it comes to sine wave. It's pulse width modulated, based on software for generating sine wave on Arduino. And let's see how it goes. I'm gonna turn on the power. We got about 6 volts. And here are the leads from each coils. They 180 degrees out of phase, so when one current and the magnetic field is building up in one coil, the opposite happens in the other, in a flip-flop fashion. So I'm connecting the leads to the drains of the transistors. One and two, right? They turned on. We're drawing 1 amp, so it's a lot of current. But what do we have on the output? We see that we have lots of pulses indicating pulse width modulation. And I have this trace, right? Okay, marker. Let's see. The secondary coil is very low impedance one, so we won't have much voltage in there. But the current should be substantial. Okay, so we got the trace. It's about 1 volt, 0.7 actually, peak to peak. Right? Let's see. We can measure the frequency. About 13 hertz, as we can see here. We can change the frequency up. Very convenient, and we have a pretty nice sine wave on the output. Now let's see what happens at this frequency. We got a little bit more, a little bit less current. See what happens if I short the output, because right now we're just measuring the voltage. So the multimeter here is set to alternating current. Right now the lead is not connected. And when I connect it, the coil, the output coil, the one in the middle, will be shorted out. So let's do that. Okay. Now we have 0.8 or 0.9 almost amps going out. The same ballpark value. But a little bit less voltage. It's not much power out, but as you can see, the input draw does not change much. This power supply shows only the input power that goes into the coils. Arduino is powered by USB cable. So it gives me a nice view how the things are working. If there's any over unity or something in this kind of setup, well, we'll see about that. So I'm going to show you right now. I'm going to connect this lead and disconnect it, and we will watch power supply input. Right, 89, disconnected, 85, 88, shorted out, 85, not much change, but there's a little bit more draw when the coil is shorted. So that's it for now. You can check out the schematic and appropriate software for Arduino at forum at overunity.com and energeticforum.com. There are two threads dealing with this idea of Clemente Figueras, so feel free to check them out, make some comments, maybe make some improvements. Alright, take care now.